On the 15th of May, in the jungle of Newell, in the heat of the day, in the cool of the pool, he was splashing, enjoying the jungle's great joys, when Horton the elephant heard a small noise. Then he heard it again, just a very faint yelp. As if some tiny person were calling for help. He looked and he looked. He could see nothing there but a small speck of dust drifting down through the air.
Help!
Most highly peculiar. He'd never heard tell of a small speck of dust that was able to yell.
Help! Please help!
You know what I think? I suspect that there must be something alive on that small speck of dust. Some sort of a person of a very small size. Too small to be seen by my elephant's eyes. If so, I should save him. Because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. There, whoever you are, all your troubles are over. I'll put you down safe on this comfortable clover.
Loof!
It was Jane Kangaroo. And the small kangaroo in her pouch said,
"Humph, too!"
Why, that speck is as small as the head of a pin. A person on that? There never has been.
I know it seems strange, but I tell you, sincerely, these extra big ears of mine heard him quite clearly.
Horton, I've known you 12 years in the jungle of Newell, and I've always considered you somewhat a fool. But talking to dust specks, that is really cuckoo. Something has got to be done about you. And something's precisely what I'm going to do.
And the small kangaroo in her pouch said,
"Me too."
Come on, Junior.
You're certainly lucky that I'm still around. This is twice in one day that you've almost been drowned.
I know, and we're eternally grateful to know that you care.
There is. There really is someone down there.
And I wish to say this. You're a most splendid friend. You've helped everyone here on this dust speck no end. You've saved all our houses, our ceilings and floors. You've saved all our churches and grocery stores.
What? You have buildings there too?
Oh, our buildings to you might seem terribly small, but to persons of our size, they're really quite tall.
But this is incredible. What are you anyhow?
Not what, sir. I'm a who.
A who? You're a who?
Yes, a who. W-H-O. Who. I live here in Whoville.
And what does a who do?
Who do? Well, I am Dr. H. Hoovy, professor of science. I've worked 50 years on my whoscope appliance to prove to the people who live in this place there are worlds beyond ours, like yours, out in space. But the people down here don't believe me. They don't.
That's perfectly right, Doc. We don't and we won't. Phooey to Hoovy! Oh, Hoovy's a jerk!
That's their opinion of me and my work.
Poor Dr. Hoovy, I can see that it's rough to have all those troubles. You sure got enough.
Anything I can do, any help I can lend, please call on me. Horton, your elephant friend.
See what I mean, Mrs. Tucanella? He talks to dust specks. Mrs. Tucanella, it's our duty to warn everyone. Spread the word, Mrs. T, throughout Precinct 23. Really?
This is highly confidential. This is just between us two. But Mrs. Tucanella told me Horton's talking to a who.
A who? Who's a who?
Well, my dear, that's just the point. There isn't any who. Horton's brain is out of joint.
For goodness sake, a who?
Now, I know you won't repeat this. Strictly entre nous. Of course. But Mrs. Tessie Tucanella is an unimpeachable source, and she says irrefutably it's indubitably a fact. Horton's schizo-witsophistic. In other words, he's cracked.
He ought to be psycho-wanwanized.
Oh, no. Psycho-wanalysis is too expensive for an elephant. I hear they charge by the pound.
Mrs. Tucanella said... Mrs. Tucanella said, undoubtedly it all goes back to some hereditary trait.
I've been reading quite a bit about heredity of late. And the uncle of Horton's cousin was an elephant named Nate, who had such grand illusions and confusions, apparitions and contusions.
And he believed he was the father-in-law of Catherine the Great.
Mrs. Tucanella told me that he's giddy as a kid.
Mrs. Tucanella told me he's litty as a mid.
Horton's flipped his lid.
Mrs. Tucanella told me that he's manic and depressive, retrogressive and recessive, and progressively, excessively, possessively, aggressively aggressive.
Mrs. Tucanella said that?
Well, my dears, if that's the case, this neighborhood's degenerating into a most unwholesome place.
With demented elephants yet.
We're going to get away from here as fast as we can get.
Dr. Hoovy, is everything all right down there?
Yes, aside from a slight breeziness, everything's all right. But it is very discouraging, Mr. Horton. Nobody believes that you exist, or that anything exists outside his own little world.
Oh, Dr. Hoovy, he talked through a hose. Who will Doc talk to? Nobody knows. Then he said,
my dear, it's perfectly
the world is a-sittin' on an elephant's nose.
An elephant's what?
An elephant's nose.
What's an elephant?
Old Doc Hoovy, that educated dope. He invented something called a hoo-hoo scope.
He looked up in the sky and he say,
my, my. It's gonna rain pickles and it's gonna pour soap.
It's gonna rain pickles and it's gonna pour soap.
Is Horton an elephant?
No, man. Horton's a pickle.
What's a Horton?
Old Doc Hoovy, that old and famous Boy Scout.
He's got all merit badges as to what it's about. He say,
hip hip hooray, we got it made today.
Cause we're all a-sittin', cause we're all a-sittin', yes, we're all a-sittin' on an elephant's nose.
That's the picture, Mr. Horton. I don't like to fuss or moan, but if it weren't for you, I'd be all alone.
I won't ever let you down. You're a person, after all. And a person is a person, no matter how small.
Who? Horton, since you've shunned my advice and still talk to that who, you have forced me to take drastic steps against you.
And the small kangaroo in her pouch said,
me too.
Yes, we've had enough of this rot. Gentlemen, do your duty.
Rot, 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 rot. It's a plot, 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 plot. We're the Wickersham brothers. We're on to your plot. Pretending you're talking to who's who are not. It's a deep, tight, evil political plot. Pretending you're talking to who's who are not. We're the Wickersham brothers. We're vigilant spotters. Hot shot spotters of rotters and plotters. And we're going to save our sons and our daughters from you. You're a bastardly, dastardly, schnastardly schnook. Trying to brainwash our brains with this gobbling hook.
We know what you're up to, pal. You're trying to shatter our morale.
You're trying to stir up discontent.
And seize the reins of government.
You're trying to throw sand in our... You're trying to kill free enterprise and raise the cost of pigs and dates and wreck our compound interest rates. And shut our schools and steal our jewels and even change our football rules. Take away our garden tools and lock us up in vestibules.
Brothers, we know your type, and we're putting a stop to this treacherous strike. We're the Wickersham brothers, we're squashing your pot. There'll be no more talking to who's who are not.
There'll be no more talking to who's who are not.
There'll be no more talking to who's who are not.
There'll be no more talking to who.
No more talking to who. Who are not.
They took Horton's clover, they carried it off to a black-bottomed eagle named Whizzer McQuaff, a mighty, strong eagle, very swift wing, and they said,
will you kindly dispose of this thing?
Then that eagle flew off with the flower in his beak.
Hidey-hi, hidey-ho, let us play hide-and-seek.
Dr. Hoovy, Dr. Hoovy, fasten your seatbelts. Tie yourself down. Batten your hatches. Sandbag the whole town.
Batten our hatches? I don't understand. What is a seatbelt? We're fresh out of sand.
Please grab hold. Hold tight, or you'll all go kaput.
Good gracious, good heavens, more trouble afoot.
All that late afternoon and on into the night, that black-bottom eagle flapped on in fast flight while Horton chased after with groans over stones that tattered his toenails and battered his bones. And at 5:45, precisely, he did it. It sure was a terrible place that he hid it. He let that small clover drop somewhere inside of a great patch of clover, 100 miles wide.
Find that, huh? I fear you are destined to fail.
And he left with a flip of his black bottom tail. Oh, my aching back, my aching trunk. If I can't find my friends on that clover, they're sunk. But I'll have to find them, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. And clover by clover by clover, with care, he picked and he plucked and he called. Are you there? But
clover by clover by clover, he found that the one he was seeking was just not around. And by noon, poor old Horton, more dead than alive, had picked, plucked, and piled up 3,000,005. All through the afternoon, hour after hour, then finally, at last, from the 3,000,000,000th flower came a voice that was hollow and ghostly and thin.
Mr. Horton, for goodness sake, where have you been?
Dr. Hoovy, quick, doctor, tell me, do tell. Are you safe? Are you sound? Are you whole? Are you well?
Am I well? Am I whole? Am I safe? Am I sound?
When that black-bottomed birdie let go and we dropped, dreadful crashing occurred. Our clocks have all stopped. At Herkimer's drugstore, the soda pops popped. Look, the Huawei department store seems like it flopped. Such civic disaster has never been topped.
Dr. Hoovy, Dr. Hoovy, you were absolutely right.
You warned us. And you warned us, but we didn't see the light.
The things you told us all were true. If we only, only, only knew.
Dr. Hoovy.
Dr. Hoovy. From here on in, we believe.
Just tell us what we have to do. Just lead us and we'll follow you. We'll save this town. We'll save this world. Just tell us what we have to do.
What to do? I wish I knew.
Keep up your courage now. Never let it sink. Things are getting better. Much better.
I think.
Horton, for almost 2 days you've run wild and insisted on talking with persons who've never existed. Such carryings on in our peaceable jungle. We've had quite enough of your bungling bungle.
Bungling bungle.
So, with the help of the Wickersham brothers and dozens of Wickersham uncles and Wickersham cousins and Wickersham in-laws whose help I've engaged, you're going to be roped and you're going to be caged.
He's going to be roped. He's going to be caged. Horton the elephant's going to be caged. He's going to be roped. He's going to be caged.
And as for your dust speck, that we will boil in a hot steaming kettle of diesel nut oil.
Boil my dust speck? No! That you can't do. It's all full of persons. I'll prove it to you.
Boil that dust speck. Boil that dust speck. Boil that dust speck.
Boil, 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 boil.
Diesel nut.
Rah, rah.
Diesel nut.
Rah, 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 rah. Diesel nut.
You hoes, don't give up. I believe in you all. A person's a person, no matter how small. And you very small persons will not have to die if you make yourselves heard. So come on now and try.
We are here, we are here, we are here.
Sound off, it's time to be heard. Your time's running out, it's your time to be heard. Give with a gargle or chirp like a bird or blunk on a blunker. Blunk on a blunker and make yourself heard. Blow on a blueser, anything goes. If you can't blow a blueser, try blowing your nose. If you can't snap your fingers, try snapping your toes. Anything, 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 anything goes. Sound off, come make yourself known. Play beedle-dee-boop on a xylophone. Play bap-bap-bap on a dinosaur bone. Play anything, neighbor. Just make yourself known. Play an octet on a hoo-ocarina. Play bubble-dee-bub on a coffee machine. Play on a pizzit. Fizz on a pizzit. Do it on something, whatever it is. All noises are needed, refined or absurd. Sound off, neighbors, and make yourself heard.
We're here, we're here, we're here, we're here. We're here, we are here, we are here, we are here. We are here, we are here, we are here.
And you surely heard that. Just as clear as a bell. Everything's going to be just perfectly swell.
I heard nothing. And you didn't either. And as for my progeny, he didn't.
Neither.
He's going to be roped. He's going to be caged. Horton the elephant's going to be caged. He's going to be roped. He's going to be caged. Horton the elephant's going to be caged. He's going to be roped. He's going to be caged. Horton the elephant's going to be caged.
Doctor, make certain that everyone's working. Look through your town. Is there anyone shirking?
Was there anyone shirking? Was every who working? Through the town raced Doc Hoovy from east to the west. But everyone seemed to be doing his best. Everyone seemed to be yapping or yipping. Everyone seemed to be beeping or bipping. But it wasn't enough, all this ruckus and roar. He had to find someone to help him make more. He raced through each building. He searched floor by floor. And just as he felt he was getting nowhere and almost about to give up in despair, in the Fairfax Apartments, apartment 12J, behind an umbrella stand hidden away, he discovered a very small shirker named Jojo standing. Just standing and bouncing a yo-yo, not making a sound, not a yip, not a chirp.
Come on, boy, you're needed!
He grabbed the young twerp and he raced with the lad toward the Eiffelberg Tower, telling him, "This is your town's darkest hour." Thus he spoke as he climbed. Then he got to the top. Then the doctor said, "Make a yip. Make a yop.
Boil that dustbeck. Boil that dustbeck.
Can't you yip? Can't you yop?"
"I just don't know, sir. I never have tried."
"Boil that dustbeck.
You better try soon, or you're going to be fried."
"Boil, boil, boil, boil."
"Well, sir, I think I'll try a yip."
"Hazelnut.
Ruff, ruff.
Hazelnut.
Ruff, ruff."
"I haven't thought, sir. I think I'll try a yow."
"Ruff, ruff, ruff, ruff. Hazelnut, boil."
"Yeah, yeah, 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 yeah." "Yup!
You're here, you're here, you're here, you're here."
That yop, that one small extra yop, put it over. Finally, at last, from that speck on that clover, their voices were heard, ringing clear through the air.
"They are there! They are there! They are there!"
The people had spoken, no matter how small, and their whole world was saved by the smallest of all.
"Yes! Yes!
Oh, be kind to your small person friends. Every who may be somebody's mother. Be kind to any who on every speck. Any one of them might likely be your brother. Oh, be kind to your small person friends. As they float around from one place to another. Remember, no matter how small, that a person is a person is a person is a person. That a person is a person after all." And friends, every who may be somebody's mother. Be kind to any who on every speck. Any one of them might likely be your brother. Oh, be kind to your small person friends as they float around from one place to another. Remember, no matter how small, that a person is a person is a person is a person. That a person is a person after all.